Erica and Brad, the police chief sent them this letter demanding answers last Wednesday, and he heard back today, but only after we started asking questions about the heroin found in a former staff member's desk. At this point, I am demanding an explanation as to where this heroin came from. The Hillside Police Chief's letter, staff, and the district superintendent demanding answers. The department still doesn't have them, but police say they got a message from the district tonight, 5 days after this was sent, explaining they're investigating. Investigating the 6 baggies packaged for delivery and filled with a white powdery substance. They were found in a past staff member's locked drawer here at the school. From, quote, the desk of the past security.
Somebody found it, somebody put it somewhere, and it was eventually turned over to my officer on the 25th.
Hillside police tested the bags at the station, positive for heroin.
It is an extremely dangerous and illegal substance.
A felony by possession alone, an upgraded felony when found on school property. And the school didn't provide a report with the drugs, a legal issue, according to the chief's letter. Quote, there are no laws allowing for police officers to possess these narcotics, let alone staff members of a high school. Mere possession without a report will prove illegal possession.
Why is that being stored? Why isn't it being turned over to a police officer who's assigned in that building 5 days a week, 8 hours a day?
So how is the district responding? This is what their public relations official sent us. Quote, the school district is aware of the communication and is currently conducting an investigation. Now, this is still an active investigation for Hillside Police, who tell me this could be a learning experience for other local districts, because this could have been a very dangerous situation. And they say in any case like this, police should be called right away. Reporting live in Hillside tonight, I'm Tara Molina, CBS 2 News.
A lot still unanswered. Thank you, Tara.